Hi guys, it's April and it's the start of a new picture. So I have been doing a page in this book. This is Joanna's Christmas for, oh my gosh, when did this book come out? This book came out in 2016. So I've been doing a page in this book, one page every year since 2016. This is the sixth picture. I guess I could have gone backwards with that. Sixth picture I've done in this book, and it's kind of a tradition I want to keep carrying on. So this is one of the first pictures I did. Some of these you will recognize. I think I have a video up for like every single picture I've done in this. Let's see if I can find the next ones. And then we have this one. And this one. And this one, which I think is probably to date my favorite. There's another one in here somewhere. There we go. And then this one, which is one of the earlier ones as well. Now, I will point out that there's a little issue with my page that I chose. I wanted to try something fancy. And so before I started this stream, I got out some painter's tape and I was seeing if I could mask out the steer head because I wanted to do something fun with the background. But painter's tape isn't like washi tape. It only works well on walls. So I pulled a little bit of the page up. I tried to fix it. We're just going to go with it. Maybe I'll get some washi tape and I can still do what I want to do. But for now, we're going to pretend like that didn't happen. Part of the reason I tried to do it off screen is because I wasn't sure it was going to work the way I wanted it to. So that's a thing. I also picked out a color swatch from Sarah Renee Clark's Color Cube. This is, oh my gosh, let's see if I can do this without spilling my coffee. This is Color Cube 1. It is number 44. I have a whole video about this system, but I thought it'd be fun to use because as you saw with those pictures, I tend to stick to a very traditional color scheme when I go into this coloring book. It's either red and green or it's like these blue tones. I wanted to break away from that a little bit and see if I could try something new. So I'm going with browns and reds. And I pulled out, I've got my Tombow alcohol, I have my Holbein colored pencils, I've got my Copics, and then I've got my Polychromos, because they all lean a little bit different in their colors, so I figured I could, you know, color match as best as I could to this, and then I could pick and choose from which ones I wanted to use. I did go through, see, I like this color system because it also comes with an interactive PDF, which is why I chose this system, or this color palette, because I found it, and then of course, I went in and I marked everything that I found with their color numbers so that future April can go back and find it if she needs to. But I will have all of these color combinations marked down below in the description after this live stream so that if you want to go and find these same colors, you certainly can. But that was enough babbling. I am going to get started. I have my sheet in the back to make sure that I don't bleed completely through, though the pages in this coloring book are extremely thick, so while it might bleed through, most likely won't bleed to the next page. I'm going to take a group. Oh my gosh. I'm going to take a drink of coffee first because I'm a little all over the place this morning. Okay. I'm going to bring my energy back down. I'm trying to not talk 100 miles or 100 words a minute. This is supposed to be relaxing. I think I'm going to definitely start with an alcohol base. And I think I want to do the deer head first. And I'm actually going to do a mix of the Copic and the Tombos. So I've got this Copic right here that I think I'm going to use as the darkest. And then this Tombow, which I'm going to use as the mid-range. And this lighter Copic as my final color. I'm going to take off my Fitbit so I'm not clanking around like a crazy person. Okay, so for the lightest color, we have E. I am Butterfingers today. I spilled alcohol. The alcohol you can get in the pharmacy, I spilled it all over my desk right before the stream. Like I said, I am Butterfingers. The coffee needs to kick in. As I was saying, the lightest color is going to be E31, which is brick beige. Then the next, the middle color, I've got P77, which I don't remember the color name for, but I have, oh goodness, I have my color chart right here. And so the 977 is a saddle brown. I only have about half of the Tombow alcohol markers. I want to get the other half. Life goal. Whoops! Did not mean to click that. We're getting such a great start right now. Okay, and then the final color is E87, which is fig. Now let's hope I don't have as much of a butterfinger when it comes to actually starting to color. Hello! Welcome to the fumble session that is me. But I am very glad you're here. Okay, so I'm gonna do this, as I always do, take the lids off of everything so that I can get marker all over my hands. Okay, I think I'm actually gonna start with the darkest color and go backwards. Normally I do like a full sweep of the light, but I'm just not feeling that this morning. So we're gonna I just love the feel of the Tombow alcohol markers in my hand. They fit so much better than the Copic. I mean, the only downside is they're not refillable. I'm actually going to zoom in for you guys. And because they're so much smaller, they're not going to last nearly as long. So, that's one downside. But I still... really enjoy the size of them. Oh, that would be perfect. I would love if we could color this book together. Oh my gosh, I just noticed that I've got glitter on this page. It's glitter all over the place. And it'll probably be here until August. And then by the time all the glitter disappears, I'll have a glitter project again. I don't know if you guys use a lot of washi tape, but if you do, what is your favorite washi tape? Yeah, these work extremely well together. I mean, it's hard not to since they're both alcohol based. My chair is talking today. Oh, you will not die on me, Fig. You will not. I also feel like I have finer control with the Tombow because of how sharp the point is on the tip of the brush. Because Copic does have kind of a chunky tip, which is fine. I do love my Copics. I love the paper in this coloring book because it is so thick. You can get away with a lot on it. But it does eat ink at the same time because it is so absorbent. I'm hoping I have a refill for the Fig. I have a feeling it might start to give up on life. It's feeling drier than the other two markers. It is the lighter colors that I always seem to use more ink from. I think it's just the way I blend.
I am liking these colors together. This is almost just putting down a base. We'll be adding a little something more when we come back with those colored pencils. Hello, welcome.
Oh yeah, that's so dry.
Let me do the other ear real quick, and then I'm gonna check to see if I have ink for E31. Hoping so. Otherwise, we will be doing an emergency Blick order and hoping that it comes before next week. I will switch to a different part of the picture.
The feel of that. I still might be able to get the deer finished. I just really
because when there's the right amount of ink, you kind of just get it all to smoothly. You feel this butteriness when you use the markers. But when they're starting to dry up, there's this scratchiness that starts to happen that just, it feels wrong.
Look at that. I knew it was coming. I do have the ink. Okay. I always seem to end up having to do like a quick refill on these streams. Oh, I still need to refill my burnt sienna from a couple of pictures back. Okay, we're gonna get paper towel out. And we are not gonna do it over top of this picture, because given the kind of energy I have been giving off today, that would just be a bad idea. Okay. Keep accidentally hitting the mouse. Okay. Step one. Open the ink. Oh yeah, you can tell by how light the other end of the marker is. It's ready. This is definitely the old style of ink refills. The new ink refills are this very streamlined cylinder shape. And I prefer the method of refilling the marker by just dropping the ink on the tip instead of taking the tip out. It's just the way I've always done it. Okay. We're looking juicy. CapEx on real quick. Okay. And that detour was brought to you by Copic. Oop, wrong side. How do I want to do the rest of this? Try and give this deer some shaping.
contouring a deer's face is an interesting experience. I'm not being particularly careful with this lighter color. At least on the inside, because however I choose to do those inner spaces, the color will end up blending out. Use my chair. She likes to talk and let her opinion be known. Okay.
I'm going to put the lightest one back. So I'm thinking about this wooden mount behind the head. I actually think I'm going to use the... I'm going to keep the fig. But I'm going to put back the tombow. And I'm going to get the darkest tombow, which is the P879, which is just brown. That's the name of it, brown. And I'm just going to use these two colors. For that back mount piece, I am going to leave like this dot part, at least I'm going to attempt to leave the dot part and do those in the reds. Once again, I'm going to start with the darker colors first. Do I want to get back out that? I might want to get back out that lighter tombow. I feel like this is just going to stay too dark. Yeah, let me get that tombow back out. Just like working with three rather than two. I think you get just a touch more range. And it'll give me a little bit more control around the decorative parts. Oops, got carried away.
dark a little too much into the light there. I have to pull that light Copic out so I can push that color back out. Fix that a touch with colored pencils instead. Slow and steady. Getting sloppy. Balance it so that both sides kind of match. part of me is using this darkest color because it makes a good framing color. The other part is using this as the edge piece so that those lines that I accidentally destroyed with the tape get cleaned up. And so you can't even tell it happened. I'll admit that I do not have the steadiest of hands. There we go. Thank you. I'm glad you like it. I definitely have marker all over my hands now. Because I can't use marker without getting it all over me. Part of me wants to do the antlers next. I think we will. It's gonna get weird doing the antlers. I have this cream color which I think I want to use with the antlers, so I might use the brick beige and then this Tombow cream color for the antlers. But I'm wondering if I also just want to, like, fade that out to page color. Like, the color of the page. But at the same time, I don't think I like that. You know what? You only live once, so I've got the beige, and then the Tombow is the P090, which, what's the name of this one? This is called Baby Yellow. And this might be one of those ones that gets a little bit of play with, colored pencils to clean up. I think I can kind of fade it out a little bit. By just using the brush tip and kind of feathering it. Before I accidentally start coloring off screen. brick beige is almost acting like a shadow. Probably shouldn't have done all of that at once, but here we are.
It's almost giving the antlers a golden kind of quality. One antler down, one to go.
There we go. Wait.
Like how I'm yelling at myself, as if I'm not the one in control of myself. I do not know
where my brain is at today. Not kicked on yet.
It has, but it hasn't. Okay, so my language skills haven't quite caught up with the awakeness that I should be right now.
I'm going to do
the full 2 hours today because technically
I think I only have one more live streaming session.
Yeah, the 18th before we hit the holidays, and probably won't stream over that weekend.
Gonna try and get as much of this done today. And hopefully I have the stuff hoping to do for the background next time. So maybe at least get a full base color down so you can see where this is going. As you've probably already guessed, I'm shooting for all of those ornaments
being red.
That will balance everything kind of nicely, but we'll see how things go as we start playing things out. Fun part about all the pictures in this book is there's this little bird in every single picture. And depending on how I'm coloring the page, sometimes that bird ends up red, sometimes that bird ends up blue. Hello, baby boy. Yep, Lessie is now tucked in the blanket on my lap. If I had been zoomed out, you would have seen him walk across the page. Now I have to figure out how I can reach the picture without disturbing the cat on my lap. I don't know if I said it. Oh, okay. Valessi, are you? There you go.
I always assume that the light source is over on this side. And I play with the shadows as if that's the case.
It's just naturally how my brain works. It wants to put the light source over there.
Okay. I think it's time for some fun with some reds. Actually, before I get too far into that, I'm going to take this dark brown and I'm going to color in the irises of this deer. Okay, so, where do we go from here? Reds. I dislike how peachy pink this Copic has gotten. So I'm probably going to stay within this realm. These two are almost nearly identical. So it's almost like I only have two. The lightest is the P856. What is that? 56 is Chinese red. And then I've got P837. Wine red. And then if we pull this Copic out, we've got this R59 Cardinal. I might actually use this brown for the darkest shading because it's got some red notes in it. I mean, I won't use a ton of it, but I'll probably only use it on the bulbs when I'm doing the bulbs. But when I'm doing things like the reindeer nose and probably these ornamental pieces, I don't think I will. Actually, I'm going to zoom out. Can see where this is at right now. So I'm going to put the brown over there for now. Real question is, do I even want to use the Copic or do I just want to go with both the Tombow since the Copics are so close anyways? Think because these pieces are so small, I'm going to hold off using the Stark Copic and just stick with the Tombow alcohol markers. I think that'll make things relatively easy. Say that now as everything goes a little bit crazy. Suppose I could have made his nose black. But, you know, going for a little Rudolph action. Oh yeah, that brown plays well with those colors.
just going to have to be careful that I grab the right color. I don't want to accidentally lose some of these details. I haven't wholly decided how I'm going to handle the chains, the garland, not sure what you want to call it, what color I want those to be. They might just end up red. We'll see how all of this ends up balancing out. welcome. Getting a little lost in what I'm doing. How do I feel about it? Not sure. We'll see how the color ends up balancing out. As I get all of these done. Definitely matching the color scheme I chose. Just it's a little outside my norm. So I don't quite have a feel for it. gonna go cross-eyed. Because none of these orderments are the same. You can't quite get into, like, a rhythm. Of, you know, just flying across the page with the same kind of, like, pattern scheme with the colors. So you kind of have to keep rethinking about how you want the shadows and stuff to fall out, while at the same time making sure you still have some of those patterns on those ornaments standing out. Sometimes you have to go just a little bit unrealistic with it. out of the lines there. But I can fix that. May have destroyed the tip of this marker just a touch. So it's harder to keep in the lines. But you always have the tendency to do that with alcohol markers anyways. Not the right color. Yeah, definitely gonna have to clean up the edges. But that's okay. And this is the only ornament that there's actually two of. I suppose the dot pattern is slightly different. Bird. Gonna drop the bright red
And I think for all of these chains... Oh, actually, no. Before I drop their bright red, I'm going to do these. But for the garland, I'm going to drop the bright, bright red. And I'm only going to use the darker red and the brown. It yet. I might actually need that. Making sure I don't smear the marker. That would be very unfortunate.
some of these smaller dots, let me tell you.
I kind of like how it's going together.
And I'm definitely glad I have these Tombow alcohol markers.
Because if I try to do some of these smaller spots with Copic,
I don't think it would end well. Some of my line work is already a little bit of a mess. A long strand. I'm trying to do this in sections so I'm not completely overwhelmed. I don't accidentally miss something. Feeling today's stream is going to be a little bit longer than normal.
But I think that's okay. However, I don't know if my hands will be able to hold up.
Because they're already starting to cramp a little bit. course, as I'm seeing this picture come together, I'm thinking, rethinking how I might do the background. I'm not sure I'm gonna stick with my original plan of what I was thinking. Actually do is pull out my pastels. Maybe. Might have to see how the pastels play with this paper. See if I want to do my chalk pastels or my pastel pencils. I don't know, what do you guys think? How would you handle the background of this? I'm starting to destroy the tip of this one, too. That's the downfall of some of the finer tips of these markers. They're very easy to chew up. Do the same thing with my pit pens. A lot of times I just kind of, I take a pair of scissors, kind of reshape the tip. A lot of times that works. Plus, since these aren't refillable, it works until the ink runs out. And then I get to start with a fresh tip again. Stomach is starting to talk. Almost there. worry too much about the spots. I go out of the lines until I figure out a little bit better what I want to do with that background. It might just be that whatever I choose, I can just use to
sharpen up those lines a little bit.
After I'm done with this, I'll go on Pinterest, check out how other people have done this page, because I'm curious. And of course, if you have this coloring book and you've done this page, I'd love to see how you did it, what color scheme you chose, and what you did for the background. Just cramping. You can kind of tell because I'm getting a little sloppier. Okay. I think I am done. Say I'm getting some of the same feel as we got from the color swatch I chose. Kind of like it. Okay. I want to pull out this Holbein. And this Holbein is sand, which is 175. I'm going to pull this out because I just want to start getting a little bit of depth. Blending some of this out. Or at least smoothing out some of the shadows that I already put in place. These these might just be lines that I can see. They're not being picked up by the camera. Might go in with this mid. So this is tan 172, and there are some small spots where I can really start rounding out the shape of those antlers. I'll have to be careful. I don't want to get too aggressive with it, but still want to get the feel for the roundness of those horns. So I don't feel like super, super flat. I think I'll also pull out probably this poly, this dark poly. So I've got this Van Dyke Brown, which is 176. And I want to use that in the deepest corners here. There's something in the subtleness of that. You start to get a feel for the shaping. The reason I started with the markers, especially since I'm literally using colored pencils that are the same color, is because you can get things done so much quicker by putting that marker base down. pencils.
Are falling asleep.
Okay. Sorry, didn't mean to slap my ring on the table. I wonder. So I've got the tan again. I wonder if we can. Some highlights going. The Holbein sepia, which is 182. Smooth out some of these blends. I know all of these things are very subtle, but I think they make a huge difference. Get a nicer subtlety. Build up. Aw, dang it. Of course, I just, like, snapped the tip off of that. Lovely. So one downside of a Holbein is just how this must have been dropped at some point, because that core is shredded. I don't even know if I can get down to the core. Yeah. This is going to be a very short pencil very quickly. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. Of course, now the core broke off into the sharpener. This pencil is going to be half the size it was when I started. I can see the core now. Please don't break. Doesn't feel loose. That's a good sign. Seriously? Ah! Okay. Well, God, grief. Yeah, I'm not gonna have any of this pencil left. I don't think I have a second one of it. It's just painful with how expensive these colored pencils are. Yeah, it's this core must just be destroyed. Because every time I get it to almost a point, it breaks off. So well. Continue to see if I can get a point off of this. Because it's not like I can use it if I can't get a point off of it on anything, not just this piece. Like a point. Okay, well, now that my pencil is half the size it used to be, here we are. Okay, Kat, you're about to fall off my lap. Well, that was a lovely adventure. Don't want to use that, but we could. I think I want to use the poly. This is the brown. This is the poly brown okra. 1/8 ochre. Excuse me, not okra. 1/8 2. And just. A little bit of that medium brown in some places. The fun part about color pencils is you start to get a little bit of texture in there. Just mixing everything up. Okay, I'm taking the Van Dyke brown again. And I'm going to go into those ornaments. And I'm going to play with those shadows. I'm going to try not to take it too far. Mostly just smoothing out some of those blends. wonder. So I've got this Holbein Carnation, which is 31. If we... bring out some of those highlights. Mostly what this is doing is smoothing out all of my gradients more than anything. Which isn't a bad thing. I think we're going to end it there for today, because I've touched everything that I think needs to be touched right now. I've just got to do a little bit of thinking about what I want to do for that background, because I think the subtlety is there with the color pencil and the marker. You've got a range of depth going on, but we need to, I don't like how the page is a cream tone, so you lose a little bit of this color scheme. It goes a little flat, so I need to think about what I want to do for the background. Like I said, I could use the chalk pastel, or I could use my pastel pencils. I'm wondering if I should get further inspiration from this and maybe do this gray-blue kind of color scheme in the background. But how do I want to touch that? How do I want to create that? How do I want to create some kind of dynamic background without just doing like flat gray-blue? So those are some things I need to think about. If you guys have any kind of recommendations on like what you would do for this background, let me know down below. I would totally love your ideas. Otherwise, this is, I think, it for this stream. We almost did 3 hours.
I think that's the longest stream I've done in a very long time. I do want to finish this up next time. So in a week from now, next Sunday at 11 Central, I will be back to finish this. I, of course, will put up a reminder on my channel so that you know that that's coming up. So if you aren't subscribed, subscribe down below so you can get the notification of the live stream, or you can set the reminder for this live stream. Also, of course, post a, hey, I'm going live on Instagram and all of those other social media. So you can follow me on those as well. Otherwise, I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your week. I hope to see you guys again next weekend. I love that you guys are here, so thank you. Whether or not you spoke up in the chat, you silent lurkers, I like you guys too. I am going to stop babbling now and see if I can find myself some lunch. So, I heart your beautiful faces. Bye.